the whole concept of dark and light, good and evil, appeals to me.
I don't look at the bright stars so much as I just look at the stars, because it's a matter of a child coming here and leaving differently.
We know that we make a difference with every student that comes through our programs, but in this week, our staff were challenged to teach in a different way. This is probably the most favorite week of the year for most of our staff. It's definitely a very special week.
Here at SCIVIS, we are exposed to children from being partially sighted to the totally blind and deaf. And they're all put together in a class, and they all come to a seminar to learn. There's no one size fits all. We have to relate to each child in a way that they can be seen.
Our mission is to inspire the spirit of discovery in all of us through the power of education and immersive engagement.
It requires effort, requires planning, but when you see that you've actually been able to connect to a child through the cultural difference of language, of education, of physical and mental ability, when you can make that connection, it is a truly rewarding experience. I've been interested in astronomy for many years. I studied it formally. Astronomy for the blind. These are subjects which are not inherently connected with each other. But to make this connection and to see that it can work, I'm very grateful to Semperis for allowing me to have this opportunity. It is really heartwarming for me to see the reaction of the children, to see how I'm being accepted in the broader community of astronomers that are working tirelessly for the blind and visually impaired. I see the children that are happy. There's no greater satisfaction than that.
We're mostly all volunteers. Your company, Semperis, has come through. It's bigger than what we anticipated.
It is so important for us to have good partners, great organizations behind us. These are the students who are going to fill the seats in your company. And we'd like to know that we're making a difference. And we try to make accommodations for every student to come to Space Camp, whether they're on the spectrum, someone who may have some hearing loss, other medical needs. But I think in doing so, we are able to reach more children and make an impact, but it also helps us in the way that we deliver our programs. As an example, with our children who are visually impaired, our staff have to think about how you're going to describe this activity. You're going to have to stretch yourself in a way to make sure that you can accommodate all the learning styles of all the students that you have on your team, and so that only makes us better.
One thing that blind children don't have a lot of are role models. NASA have a scientist who's been blind from birth, and he comes every year and talks to the kids about employment, college, life in general as a blind adult. And he gets asked questions about his life and his careers. He gets questions sometimes that don't pertain to science and education. He's been asked, "Do you have any friends?" And he gets asked, "Were your parents mad at you when they found out you were blind?" And those questions can only be answered by someone who's been there, done that. And he switches from that role of education to personal experience, and it's very important. And I've always said, if a child comes here and doesn't learn about the moon, doesn't learn how the shuttle launches, and finds out that they can grow up and have friends and have a full life, I think that's more important.
Semperis not only has a program called Force for Good, but live the program, encourage the program, advertise the program. The force for good in my environment means being good to others. And these others are the blind and the visually impaired children. It is a program where it's not just lip service. there's a physical and a material commitment by the company to support a Force for Good initiative. When we do these projects, I'm always looking for volunteers. People step forward because they want to help. People want to be involved. People want to give back to the community.
When the program first started, and we came down with 20 kids, and the next year there was 40 kids. As we grew, I started to see the social aspect of the camp. That, yeah, the math and the science is really good, but for children who are in the public school stream, it's unusual for them to have blind and visually impaired peers in their school, maybe even in their county or their district. And to come here, walk into an environment where there's 50, 60, 70, 150 blind and visually impaired kids, that may be their first time. I had a child stop me, probably 6, 7 years ago, and say, "Thank you for creating Planet Blind." And I looked at him and I said, "What?" And he said, "When I come here, I feel like I'm on another planet." He says, "Everybody is the same as me. I don't have to explain why I wear sunglasses. I don't have to explain why I have a cane. I have friends that don't have to explain why they have a telescope to look at things. And when I'm here, everybody's the same and everybody gets it." And I went, "Thank you. That's probably the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me." Yeah. Thank you.